About 4 or 5 years ago, I changed my offensive philosophy. I had an assistant coach who came back from being on the road, and he came in and said, hey, we need to look at what we're doing offensively a little differently. And so he really opened my mind to a more movement-based philosophy in terms of hitting and hitting the ball hard as opposed to hitting the ball on the ground. We really focused on hitting the ball to the outfield and hitting the ball in gaps where there's only 3 outfielders as opposed to the defensive infielders, where there's a lot more in a tiny space. From there, we sort of figured out how we wanted to work that within practices. And we started out by putting a different colored bungee cord across the top of our hitting cage and putting it out 18 feet from the home plate area, knowing that if somebody hit the ball in front of the line, then they were usually hitting a pop-up. And if they hit it beyond it, it was a good chance it was going to be a line drive. Finding a gap to the outfield. So that was sort of the beginning of it and how we've evolved here. And then moving forward, incorporating hit tracks into our day-to-day work with our hitters. If we can be consistent with our movements, then we're going to be more effective hitters. The hit tracks allows you to see that, both within the video and within the numbers. So what we always look for is double green, your ideal exit velocity and your ideal launch angle. And so if we're seeing double greens across the board on the hit tracks, then we know that we're being really consistent. And that consistency in practice in individual hitting sessions just sort of carried over into game situations as well. We use the session reviews a lot, and we will match up individual swings with the video and then do the compare function where we can compare a good swing with a bad swing so that they can see what the difference is in and when they're being effective and sort of consistent with their movements and when they're not. The first thing that we focus on is hitting the ball hard. If you're hitting the ball not so hard and hitting it in the air, then it's probably not going to be a great combination. So we really look to work from the bottom up and getting that bottom base movement working. If she focuses on getting her lower half going and getting her hips moving and going forward at the ball, then she's going to be effective. As a coach, I'm always trying to evolve and to better myself in terms of my teaching and mentoring. And if I can do that with each individual player in a way that's going to reach them, I think it's a no-brainer from my perspective.